Using analog inputs for temperature monitoring and control is a really cool feature of the GS4 drive. Normally, you would have a motor with a sensor built in that you wire to the GS4 drive. But you could use it for anything you want. For example, could you use this feature to monitor a temperature of a room so you know if there's a fire and need to shut that motor down? Sure. Of course, you would normally use the drive's fire mode for that, but this would be another way to do it. Wherever the temperature sensor comes from, the drive can use that to monitor the temperature and issue warnings, faults, and automatically back off the motor speed or even shut the motor down. The GS4 can use either PTCs or RTDs for temperature sensing. At a certain temperature, a PTC's resistance changes dramatically. When you buy one, you just pick one that changes at the temperature you want. The GS4 drive just looks for that rapid change to know when things have gone south. RTDs, on the other hand, have a very linear response to temperature change, so you can just buy one device and then just pick whatever temperature you want the GS4 to react to. RTDs give you a lot of control over fault reporting and drive behavior. When the temperature rises to level 1, which you specify, a delay timer starts. If the temperature is still above level 1 at the end of the delay, the GS4 can drop the motor speed to a value that you set. If the temperature falls back below level 1 for greater than the delay time, then the motor will resume normal operation. If the temperature reaches level 2, the drive does whatever parameter 639 says it should do. It can just issue a warning, issue a fault and ramp to a stop, issue a fault and coast to a stop, or do nothing. Once the temperature reaches level 2, the only way to get the motor to resume normal operation is to clear the fault. It doesn't automatically recover like the level 1 condition did. Let's do an example using an RTD so we can see how this works. For both types of temperature sensors, connect the device to analog output number 2. Because it can be set up as a true current source that can drive a fixed current through the sensor to create a voltage we can measure with an analog input. And since the resistance changes with temperature, the voltage we read will be proportional to that temperature. You can use any analog input. We'll use input number 3 for this example because I have the other inputs set up for demos and other videos. By the way, could you drive this sensor with your own current source? Sure. You might want to do that if you're already using analog output 2 for something else. But in general, using the GS4's current output feature is so easy and convenient, there's usually no need to spend the extra money on an external supply. I'm using the RTD in this room temperature sensor from Automation Direct simply because that's what I had laying around. But any PT100 RTD will do. Great, we're wired up, so let's configure the drive. Analog input 3 only reads voltages, so there's no switch to flip. If we were using analog input 1 or 2, we would need to make sure that the switch on the terminal board is set to the 0 to 10 volt position. In parameter 404, we tell the drive to use analog input 3 as the temperature monitor by selecting N11. Analog output number 2 needs to output a fixed current, so we need to make sure his switch is set for current output. And we want to set the fixed output at 9 milliamps, which is 45% of the 0 to 20 milliamp range. Of course, make sure analog output 2 is set for 0 to 20 milliamps, not 4 to 20 milliamps. Why did we choose 9 milliamps? Because it's enough to reliably drive the RTD without having to worry about the RTD heating up and throwing off our temperature measurements. Okay. Our hardware is wired and configured. Now let's set up the fault conditions. We need to tell the GS4 drive the voltages these temperatures generate. If you have a motor with a built-in RTD, then look at the manufacturer's datasheet. That'll tell you what temperature you need to watch out for. The example in the GS4 drive's user manual has a chart that'll give you some idea what to expect. These motor insulation classes will have max temperatures of this, and you'll want to start protecting the motor a good 15 to 20 degrees below that. If you pull up a PT100 RTD chart online, you'll see that these temperatures of the PT100 RTD will be at these resistances. We're pushing 9 milliamps through the RTD, so it's easy to calculate the voltages created. By the way, it's called a PT100 RTD because the RTD sensor will be at 100 ohms at 0 degrees Celsius. So for our demo, we'll just pick some numbers in that range, which correspond to these temperatures. Again, normally you would make these whatever you need for your system. Just be sure level 1 parameter is non-zero and below level 2. When we hit level 1, let's delay 5 seconds, and if we're still at level 1 after the 5 seconds, drop the drive's frequency to 2 Hz. Now remember, this number has to be greater than 0 if you're using an RTD. Putting a 0 in here turns off the RTD function and enables the PTC function. If we hit level 2, then immediately do whatever is in parameter 639. In our example, we'll fault and ramp to a stop. Well, that was a lot of parameters, so here's a summary of what we just did. Okay, let's try it. I'll enable the motor, and here's a voltmeter that's across the RTD so we can keep an eye on the temperature generated voltage going into the drive. Here are the voltages for levels 1 and 2 that we just set a moment ago. I'll take a soldering iron and heat up the RTD, and sure enough, when we reach the level 1 voltage, the GS4 waits 5 seconds, then reduces the motor speed to the 2 Hz drop frequency we specified, and generates an overheat fault in the drive. If we cool the sensor off, the motor resumes speed and the fault goes away after the voltage has stayed below level 1 for that 5 second delay we set. That level 1 delay works on level 1's heating and cooling transitions. Now if we heat it up again, it passes level 1, drops the frequency, and generates a fault, just like before. Let's keep heating it to level 2. Sure enough, the motor ramps to a stop with no delay, exactly what we asked for. Now one thing to be aware of, once the motor hits level 2, it doesn't automatically recover, even if the temperature drops all the way back to normal. You have to clear the fault. I'll hit the stop on the keypad, but you could also clear it remotely from a PLC, for example. Everything is pretty much the same when using a PTC device, except since the PTC rapidly changes when it reaches its limit, you only have one level to set to look for that transition, and the default value of 50% is usually fine. The only other difference for PTC devices is you need to make sure that the RTD level 1 drop frequency is 0. That tells the drive we're using a PTC sensor and not an RTD. Well, that ought to be enough to get you started with temperature monitoring on the GS4 drive. Click here to learn more about the GS4 drive. Click here to learn about Automation Direct's free support options. And be sure to click here to subscribe to Automation Direct's channel so you'll be notified when new videos become available.